welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I think this has been the most requested video ever, like skincare routine. So I thought, why not? For me personally, my skincare routine doesn't make sense because, to show that this is a routine, because I switch up at least one product every single week because I keep trying new products. But I was like, you know, why not? Like, I'll just show you the products which I'm using currently right now, which are like my absolute favorites. I really, really thoroughly enjoy them. I've been using them for more than like a month or two for sure. So let's get started. Before starting, I just want to say that I am a skincare enthusiast. I love skincare, I love different products, I love knowing about skincare, but I am supremely lazy as well. So I want my routine to be as simple as possible. I hate sitting for 5 minutes, 10 minutes doing things. It's just not my piece of cake. I'm extremely lazy. So I keep it very simple, especially during the morning. I keep it very, very basic. And anyways, I don't use any actives in the morning. So it's quite simple, quite basic. And there are even a few things which I changed in my routine because of the monsoon. So I thought, why not? Like, you know, I'll give you a few tips about monsoon as well, because humidity, this monsoon, I hate it. One more reason for me to do this video is, like, I usually don't show skin prep in my normal makeup videos because it gets really long. So I thought if I do one such video and keep it, like, every time you ask, I can, you know, redirect you to this video. Because basically for me, there's the only step which will be in between this, my skincare and my makeup, is a primer. That also I skip on sometimes. So I prep my skin really, really well is what I always say. So I thought, why not show you guys my skin prep and how I do my morning skincare routine. So let's start off with cleansing. Now, I personally don't cleanse my face in the morning. At least I used to not cleanse my face. I used to cleanse my face until a year ago, like morning, evening, every time. But since past 1 year, I think during the winter, last month, 2020 winter, and until like the summer, I didn't wash my face in the morning at all, because that's the period of like my skin where it's normal. It's not like oily. It's very normal type of skin. So I don't want to, like, you know, over cleanse my skin. So I just used to, like, wake up, cleanse my skin with water, and then I used to go in with my serums and moisturizer, sunscreen. So my skin has become kind of oily during this monsoon. Imagine, like, even during the summer, my skin was like normal. Like, it was a little oily, but I could still use heavy creams, and it was like very, very, like, proper. But once the monsoon started, everything I started applying became really, really heavy for my skin. So I had to switch up the products. Long story short, my skin has become oily during the monsoon. So I am cleansing in the morning with a cleanser. So for cleanser, I'm using this Dermaweave Hydra Cleanser. This cleanser, you guys, like, if you have sensitive skin, acne prone skin, dry skin, oily skin, anybody, you will thank me later. This is such a good cleanser. It's an extremely, extremely hydrating cleanser. It doesn't strip your face whatsoever. It just does what it's supposed to. It just cleanses your face. So that's the reason I love using this in the morning. It's a very hydrating cleanser. So, like, in the morning, it doesn't strip away my skin off, like, you know, the essential oils, but just cleanses the skin and, like, does the job. It's a supremely nice one. And the best part is that there's no SLS, no soap, no fragrance, no parabens, and no lanolin. So this is the Australian brand, but I think it is available on Amazon as well. I will link it below. You can definitely give this a try. Such a hydrating cleanser. Doesn't strip your skin, does the job really well. If you have, like, dry or sensitive skin, you definitely have to give this a try. So it has, like, really good ingredient. It has even has lactic acid in it, so it exfoliates your skin. It has really, really mild cleansers, like mild surfactants. So really good one. You can definitely give this a try. So I'm just going to first cleanse my face with this. I just went and wet my face a little bit. So face is cleansed. Next, let's move on to toner. I use a very basic toner, like just something which adds a layer of, like, liquid thing to my face in the morning, nothing with active. So I'm just going in with this Organic Harvest Neem Tulsi Toner. I'm just going to spritz it on my face. The smell of it is really strong, like, it's not artificial fragrance, but it has neem and etc. So there's a lot of neem smell in it. I told you my routine is very, very simple. So after this, I go in with my vitamin C. So I'm just going in with this Claire's Vitamin Juice Drops, and I'm just going to take that 2-3 drop on my hand. Now this is a very good vitamin C to start off with. It's like 5% ascorbic acid. I have one more option for vitamin C. This is the Eclat 20% vitamin C. I don't know if you can see, but I've used quite a lot of it. So I really like the effect it had on my skin. Like, you know, a lot of scars which I got recently did go away really fast when I was using the serum. But like I told you, my skin is not able to take a lot of heavy products currently. So, you know, this has become really heavy. Like when I start applying this, my face starts sweating. So this happened to me with my moisturizer as well. The Mamaearth oil-free moisturizer is like my favorite moisturizer. But nowadays, like if I apply that, I start sweating so quickly. So it's basically like, you know, if you start apply something and if you start sweating like immediately, like a cream or something, then basically it means that it is quite heavy for your skin. So I would definitely try this in winter for sure. But like for now, my skin, it's too heavy, so I start getting tiny bumps. But if you have dry skin or somebody, you can definitely give this a try. After this, I just go in with my moisturizer. Now again, I cannot use a very heavy moisturizer like I told you, so I stopped using the Mamaearth one and I've been using the Sugandha Aloe Green Tea Gel. And it has aloe vera, green tea, panthenol, hyaluronic acid, so it's very liquidy. You can see it's a very thin formula, so it's not like heavy on the skin. So if you have dry skin, you can use that as a serum, so because it has like incredible ingredients. But if you have oily skin, you can definitely just use that as like a moisturizer. So because it's very lightweight, like it doesn't like, you know, irritate your skin or doesn't become too heavy for your skin during the monsoon. So I've been really enjoying that one. I think I'm almost out. Like I'm like, you know, through here, I'm like almost out. One more thing is I can't skip that heavy moisturizer and use this like, you know, a serum plus moisturizer, because like I will definitely go in with sunscreen and sunscreens are quite heavy. So you can avoid a moisturizer if you do have really heavy skin. So for sunscreen, I'm going in with this Dermaco Pure Zinc Matte Sunscreen Gel. It's a pure mineral sunscreen. That is the sunscreen which suits my skin. So I take like good amount of sunscreen, because that's how much you're supposed to apply. You need to take good amount of sunscreen and like layer your skin. Don't freak out, it does disappear. Like it does like look like a lot when you initially apply it, but it does sync up to your skin. It takes about 5 to 10 minutes to sync up completely, but yeah, because you are supposed to, you know, apply a lot of sunscreen. So for my last step, it is a lip balm. So this is the Organic Harvest Shea Butter, you know, lip balm. Now I do apply sunscreen for sure, because like if I flip the camera, you can see that there's a lot of sunlight which comes into my room throughout the day. Like post 1 o'clock to 5 o'clock, I have a lot of sun which comes into my room, so I have to stay protected. So I always use sunscreen even if I'm indoors, and like if I shut the curtains, I won't. If I'm opening the curtains for filming, then I do use a sunscreen because I don't want my pigmentation to aggravate even more. So yeah, it's been 10 minutes. Like you see, the white cast is not there so much. Maybe a little on the forehead because it got into the hair. But I really don't care if it even has a white cast, because I do apply makeup and you cannot see the white cast through the makeup. But I do understand a lot of people just want to wear sunscreen on their own. So you can definitely give the Dermaco one a try. But other than that, Neutrogena Zinc one is like the best ever, but it does have a lot of white cast. So yeah, my skin does break out. I do have a lot of scars, a lot of pigmentation, but that's how my skin is. My skin is extremely sensitive in the sense that it can, you know, freak out for a little change in weather, a little change in food, little change in product. It freaks out like this, like immediately it freaks out. So but it has been a lot better. And last month I had a little bit of dairy, so there was a lot of purging which happened, like not purging but breakouts which happened. And uske wale my skin was actually doing really well, but during the monsoon, when, you know, there was a period where I didn't realize that the products I was using were wrong, so it kind of, you know, made little tiny comedones here and there. Yeah, that is what I wanted to tell you, that your skin changes like with every season, so you need to switch your products up according to your skin. So maybe if some product you're using and you're sweating a lot, maybe that's, you know, product is a little heavy on your skin, and try switching like, you know, down by like into watery consistency or anything if you feel like your hair creams are being too heavy. So yeah, that I think sums up today's video. Yeah, if you like the video, make sure hit the like button and comment below your skincare routine, the products you use. I would definitely love to check that out and maybe try a few products and then review it for you guys as well. So yeah, that sums up today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.